Today in 2020, the whole world is fighting against the coronavirus. Coronavirus disease 2019 is simply known as COVID-19 because the disease was first identified in 2019 in Wuhan, the capital of China's Hubei province, and has since spread globally, resulting in the ongoing 2019 to 2020 coronavirus pandemic. Back in history, there was another pandemic which once engulfed the whole world, a century ago, the 1918 flu pandemic, also known as Spanish flu. It was unusually deadly influenza pandemic lasting from January 1918 to December 1920. It infected 500 million people, about a quarter of the world's population at the time. The death toll was estimated to have been anywhere from 17 million to 50 million, and possibly as high as 100 million, making it one of the deadliest pandemic in human history. Health facilities in those days were not as advanced as that of today, which led the death toll to rise drastically. Even today, there is no clarity in the origin of this contagion, and controversies still continue. Then why this contagion is called a Spanish flu? The contagion is said to have originated during a spring season in the early 1918. But it spread across entire Europe, months before the end of the First World War. During the initial stages of the outbreak, those countries which were in the forefront of the war, Germany, United Kingdom, France and US, did not disclose the exact death toll or the outbreak of the pandemic to the soldiers or to the public. Also, they banned the media from reporting the news of this kind by imposing wartime censorship restrictions. But in Spain, the media were free to report the epidemic's effects as the country followed a neutral approach to the war. That allowed other countries as well to report the outbreak details from Spain, including the death toll and other related details. The confirmation of the viral infection in Alfonso XIII, the king of Spain of that period, created more panic and was of the media attention. It was due to this very reason that made to portray Spain as this pandemic's country of origin and the worst affected victim. Thus this contagion was happened to be called a Spanish flu. Usually in the case of this kind of influenza, those who were more affected or for whom the death happens were of either children or people of old age. But in the case of this pandemic, the death toll of the people who were between ages 20 and 40 were alarming. Though there exists various types of speculations regarding the origin of this contagion, these are the ones which were found lying close to reality, both logically and scientifically. It has been reported at a military training troop in Kansas in America. The flu was first seen in Private Albert Chedil, who was a mess cook at that troop known as Fort Riley. There were around 26,000 soldiers who were getting trained for the war. When these infected soldiers joined the rest of the troop who were camped in Europe, the flu spread among them as well. It is said that the flu came to Europe in this way. References in the book titled The Great Influenza, written by the famous writer John M. Barry, tends to establish the above arguments. Another argument claims that tens of thousands of soldiers in France, who were actively involved in the war between 1916 and 1917, died in different type of viral flus. Excerpts from famous historians' notes depicts that the symptoms similar to that of the Spanish flu were found in those soldiers. Later it's found that the flu had spread from domestic animals. Another claim is that the flu spread from the laborers who had come from China and that in turn spread among the soldiers. But another strong argument made by Andrew Prince Smith, who was a political scientist, was that the flu had originated in Austria. The majority of the people who died were of the ages between 20 and 40. Due to this very reason, the Spanish flu was more disastrous than other flus. The pandemic brought about much disaster in America. Nearly 675,000 people died due to this pandemic in America, out of which nearly 5 lakhs of them were the youth between 20 and 40 years of age. In 1917, the life expectancy in America was 51 years, where it counted back to 39 years on the very next year, 1918. Figures showed that the death toll in Persian province, who showed their presence strongly in the war front, were somewhere between 2 lakhs and 9 lakhs. The British reported that nearly 20 lakh people died in India. But it's also said that the death toll was around 2 crores. This flu came to India via the British soldiers who had returned from the war. But in India, the flu was known as Bombay flu. That might have been the tactics imposed by British who ruled over India during that period. It's said that the flu had spread from Bombay to other parts of the country. Bombay and Madras stood as the worst affected areas in India. The rulers were able to control the flu from spreading to Calcutta regions, which otherwise would have been a huge disaster. The number of people died in France were nearly 4 lakhs, same was the case with other countries in Europe. In Japan, nearly 3 lakhs people died. During those days, Japan prohibited the journey by sea. Spain was said to be the country of origin of the 1918 flu. But the death toll in Spain was stopped below 3 lakhs. They assumed that the flu came to their country from France, and they had their own theory, which stated that the flu came from Spanish migrant workers, who were involved in French railway-related jobs. Approximately 90% of the people in Germany were affected by this flu, out of which mostly 30% of them surrendered to death. There also the people who died were mostly youth. There were countries who escaped from the grasp of this contagion. Those were some of the island countries who stayed isolated. Fiji Islands were few among them. But in Australia, the death ratio was comparatively very less. The 1918 flu pandemic occurred in 3 waves. The second wave was more destructive than the first one. The third and the last wave was more benign, as many people were already immunized, was able to put the pandemic under control towards the spring season 1919. And finally the virus got disappeared from the earth by the summer of 1920. There was no other pest ailments which had given such a drastic blow to the humankind. There were several reasons which caused the pandemic to affect 1/4 of the world's population at that time. The main reason being inadequate medical facilities due to the lack of antiviral drugs, antibiotics, respirators, specialized intensive care units and vaccines. Another key reason was the era itself, that is the period between 1914 and 1918, the period which witnessed one of the bloodiest war in the human history. The First World War.